is the portrait of a friendly city. A typical city in the Dominion of Canada. A city wrought out of primitive wilderness by men of vision, faith, and courage. A community whose citizens are fulfilling a prophecy made many, many years ago. Long years ago, Macassar Bay at the western end of Lake Ontario was an inhospitable wilderness of virgin forest, winding creeks and impenetrable swamp, frequented only by Indians breaking trails westward. Here in August 1669 came the adventurous French explorer Sieur de La Salle to be the first white man to set foot on the site of the present city of Hamilton, Ontario. To La Salle, ever conscious of the force of destiny, the site must have held historical portent. For as he beheld the great heights, he made a prophecy.
Ici s'élèvera une grande ville.
Here one day there shall be a great city. Yes, here one day there's a great city. But years were to elapse before the wilderness resounded to the axe blows of settlers and the labors of the United Empire Loyalists. Years which immortalized the names of Robert Land, Richard Beasley, and Sir Allan McNab as builders of a great Canadian metropolis. Years which finally brought Hamilton, over a century ago, to the official status of a city. The years unfolded swiftly, and to the thousands of visitors who today accept Hamilton hospitality, the centennial birthday portrait of the city shows the changes wrought by the men and women who have now brought Hamilton City in point of population, and to a position of even greater importance in the industrial, commercial, and cultural life of Canada. Marked in decades rather than in centuries, Hamilton is mature by the yardstick of years. But by the standard of its citizen accomplishments, Hamilton is still young, progressive, and ambitious. The prophecy of August 1669 has been fulfilled. But perhaps the story of Hamilton is better told by its own people.
As we who earn our living in Hamilton can testify, the city must pay tribute to the fortunate choice of location made by those who settled here. For Hamilton is in the geographic center of teeming activity, a city easily accessible overnight from the major cities of the eastern United States. No matter how you enter Ontario by road, by way of Buffalo, Niagara Falls, Lewiston, Detroit, or Port Huron, modern smooth highways will bring you to or near Hamilton. With its many beautiful entrances, a program of constant highway improvement, and a location in the center of the Dominion's wealthiest consuming population, the city is truly the hub of transportation. As a result of those excellent highway system, gasoline motive power has naturally come to the transportation fore. Modern, streamlined motor coaches provide a luxurious link between Hamilton and the principal Canadian and American centers. Two of the world's greatest railroad systems service the city, the Canadian National and Canadian Pacific. The Toronto, Hamilton, and Buffalo Railway, with headquarters in Hamilton, has direct connections with the important American systems. To those who prefer air travel, there are airport facilities.
Although Hamilton on the map is an inland city, it is actually a great port. A port with a landlocked harbor which in normal times handles more tonnage than Halifax.
Yes, I believe that The port of Hamilton is about as snug a spot to cast your anchor as you'll find anywhere. And you're always sure of a good berth. During the navigation season, it's about as busy a place as you'd care to see. The big collection of docks, about 24 of them, are just loaded with raw goods coming in and manufactured goods going out. And what with the regular service on the Great Lakes, up the St. Lawrence River, and to the Atlantic and Pacific seaboards, it's a really thriving port. But perhaps its most unusual feature is that amazing natural sand strip through which you pass, coming and going, and which makes Hamilton a completely landlocked harbor.
Yes, Hamilton is indeed a transportation hub, but its neighbors know it best for the scenic beauty that surrounds it. Many visitors enter Canada at Niagara Falls, where the breathtaking waters ever justify themselves as the world's seventh wonder. As they enter the historical Niagara Peninsula, visitors are constantly reminded of the unfortunate War of 1812. But perhaps new visitors to the peninsula are inspired most by the unsuspected beauty of one of the continent's greatest fruit belts. In blossom time, the riot of color, the glorious variety of bloom, and the ever-present luxurious perfume which saturates an entire peninsula, these are things to be remembered by even the most casual visitor. But this fertile fruit belt is more than a glory to the eye of the visitor. It is a tremendous economic asset, an asset which has helped to make Hamilton a prime center for agricultural activities of all kinds, research, manufacture, and export. And so the man of the soil becomes an important figure in our portrait. For as the prairie of the West constitute the nation's granary, so the Niagara Peninsula constitutes its greatest fruit mart. The incoming visitor, if he wants information about places and activities, need only ask any Hamilton resident.
Things to do, sights to see, places to relax? Sure, we have them. We can give you most anything, whether you're booked for a short or a long stay. A lot of us here go in for sailing. The Royal Hamilton Yacht Club is a busy place, winter or summer. And there's almost always a good breeze. There aren't many things that I enjoy more after a hot day at the office than a cool, relaxing sail over Burlington Bay. The singing wind in your face, a full sail glinting in the sunlight, the soft lap of cool, swift-flowing water. What more would you ask? But perhaps you prefer a more quiet type of recreation and would like to join the visitors to the famous sunken rock garden. There are as many as 5,000 visitors a day, I'm told. And no wonder. Their equal is not found in all America. Few are the people who have not marveled at the ever-changing vistas of rock, sky, and bloom. For though the rock gardens are entirely man-made, they possess the distinctive charm of a natural beauty spot. But I believe that the poet better expressed it when he said, "A thing of beauty is a joy forever." One beauty spot with special significance is the old mill wheel, a memorial to the writer of the nostalgic ballad, "When You and I Were Young, Maggie." Hamilton is justly famous for its parks. The preservation of natural assets, the modern landscaping, the beautifully set boulevards and the rose gardens all truthfully indicate a beauty-conscious administration and citizenship. And like all waterfront cities, Hamilton has a popular ferry service to a park, LaSalle Park. But it is for the children that the parks provide the most enjoyment. Here in settings of real beauty, where there is no lack of supervision, no traffic hazard, and all the water and space that their young hearts can desire, here the small fry can enjoy themselves in their own lusty fashion. Perhaps no municipality can lay claim to greater achievements than the health, education, and opportunity that it can provide for its future citizens. It may be that for your personal recreation, you like a sport in which you can take an active part. If that means golf, lawn bowling, tennis, swimming, or riding, then you'll find us more than prepared to take care of you. If you like to watch the Bangtails run, the Hamilton Jockey Club has one of the finest tracks in the entire country. Hamilton athletes and teams have, in international competition, established some international and world records of which we are pretty proud. The city's location does a lot towards encouraging these events. For field sports, the city is especially well equipped. The Civic Stadium has an excellent track and field, which has in the past been honored by the British Empire Games and the Canadian Championships. Things to do, places to relax, you'll find them in Hamilton, all right, with an abundance of natural beauty spots and a sports-minded citizenship. Hamilton offers you as a visitor or a prospective resident a rich experience in living and entertainment.
Yes, Hamilton has many attractions, some of them unique. One unusual feature that catches the eye of the visitor is the open-air market. Located in the heart of the city, it is the largest open-air market in Canada. As a contrast to this type of trading, Hamilton has shops and stores to fill every need. Large, modern department stores feature every type of merchandise and do a volume of business that reflects the large tourist trade and the prosperity of the city. As a retail shopping center, Hamilton attracts buyers from all over the continent. The city is also well known for its gift and specialty shops, featuring imported china, precious metals, and gems. Fine English china, particularly, is a magnet for both residents and visitors. There is an ageless appeal to truly fine china, and many a souvenir leaves these stores to make its permanent home across the border. Possibly more than any other single factor, the accommodation offered to tourists have influenced their opinions of a city. In this respect, Hamilton hotels have, by their splendid service and cuisine, won an excellent reputation for the city itself. For many visitors, the smaller, family hotels have provided an ideal and inexpensive home away from home. But the people who know and love Hamilton best are those who live there and take an active interest in its civic, its cultural, its religious life. Those who call Hamilton home. For Hamiltonians are proud of their homes and the total absence of slum districts. They are proud, too, of their schools, for the authorities have developed within the city limits a complete educational program to carry students from grade school to university. Hamilton churches, old and young, are imbued with the vital quality of warmth and understanding, so necessary in ministering to the soul. But it is in the care of bodily needs that the city has truly achieved worldwide recognition. The Hamilton Mountain Sanitarium, with its beautiful and healthful location, is recognized as one of the finest tubercular institutions in the world. Perhaps it is in the care of tubercular children that the sanitarium performs its greatest service. To many people, Hamilton is many things, port, park, and playground. But to the worker, it is an industrial giant.
Hamilton claims to be a city of beauty and industry. Anyone who has viewed our city from the Niagara Escarpment will admit its beauty. But no one who has seen the glow of the furnaces across the bay can ever doubt our industry. The real secret of our wealth lies in our productiveness. To live, you must produce. And in producing, Hamilton has come to be the most highly industrialized of all Canadian cities. Our 500 industries represent the greatest diversity of manufactured products of any single city in the Dominion. More than 30% of our population is employed by industry alone. You might say with all truthfulness that Hamilton is the home of United States industry in